formerly known as Gigaba, Norma Mngoma exposes her former husband for being a paranoid, secretive, obsessed with porn and power-hungry. Hi, T-Squad, and welcome to the T-World. Norma Mngoma gives insight about how they would frequently visit the Gupta's house and later see him come out with bags of money each time after their visits. Norma says she did not know what's wrong or right about it. She just knew that their visit is a frequent thing. Explaining the chaotic confiscating of her gadgets by the hawks at her ex-husband's demand, Norma says he got paranoid about what she knew. When he found out that I wanted out from our marriage, so he made a plan to have my gadgets taken, she said. I can't put myself in his thoughts, but I think that he's paranoid. We visited the Gupta's house together, where I think he thinks I took pictures. They used to ask us to hand in our phones outside, but I'd get bored, so I'd fetch my phone. This year, he was asking me a lot of questions about what I remember from those meetings. He saw I wanted to leave the marriage, and now he's worried about what I know, she said. I love to take pictures. I didn't know they were supposed to be secret, she said. At his squad, Norma Mngoma confidently spilled the beans that she and her husband would dine with the Guptas. I never received a call from them, but we were frequently there at the Gupta's house, and they used to come to our house too, especially when he was in the Department of Public Enterprises, she added. She said that the Guptas were advising him who to appoint, but that they wouldn't speak in front of her. There was a lot of cash all the time. He used to use that money for a lot of things, and sometimes give to his sister or his personal life, like our wedding and our honeymoon. They were always there to help financially. At his squad, Norma says her husband of 6 years had so much ambition to become a South Africa's president. He wanted it so much, but that led to the suffering of their marriage. Gigaba's ex-wife says he went too far when he betrayed South Africa's former president, Jacob Zuma, because he treated him like a son. She says he could be the minister again, needed be. Because things changes in the politics. They aren't predictable, she says. In denial of ever wanting to kill him, Norma says it was all a plan and used as a cover. Norma revealed that her ex-husband is too obsessed with being special and is power-hungry, verily. She went further to explain that she knows that this whole theory of people trying to kill him is all in his head, because if there was someone who wanted to kill him, he would always have his bodyguards with him, but they go home and he wouldn't drive himself either. For me to try and kill him, that's a complete lie. The hawks wanted to cover that, and that is why they got involved. He's too obsessed about being so special. When he was forced to resign as finance minister, he was very angry about the blue lights police guard that was revoked. He became such an angry person, he told police minister Bekicele that there were people outside with guns that wanted to kill him, but there was nobody there. Sometimes when you are in power for too long, you become attached to it, she said. When she was finally asked about the video of his private parts that went viral, Norma Mngoma says the video was not sent for her, but one of his many side chicks, since he has many of those. She also revealed that he is obsessed with porn and sexting. He is always watching porn. For him, it's a fantasy, she said. That's it for now, T-Squad. Do leave your comments down below. I love you.